What's next? One day after the release of the report on the Jerry Sandusky scandal, the people in charge of governing Penn State met publicly. Good evening. I'm Ron Martin.
And I'm Kim Lemon. The Board of Trustees again took responsibility for failing to stop the Penn State scandal sooner. But tonight, it went further.
News 8's Matt Barcaro was in Scranton when this was announced at today's board meeting. He joins us live. Good evening, Matt.
Good evening, Ron and Kim. The leader of the Board of Trustees said everything that happened at Penn State leading up to Jerry Sandusky's arrest in November was a, quote, collapse in leadership. Yesterday, the board promised to start implementing the recommendations from the Freeh report as soon as possible, and that started today. Clearly, the Freeh report is still top of mind for the Penn State Board of Trustees. It was the first thing the board chair addressed.
We will take every action to ensure that events like these never happen again in our university community.
And the trustees who hired Louis Freeh praised the investigation.
I think that the report shows that this university values the search for truth and is willing to engage in painful and critical third-party criticism as well as self-examination.
Some members of the public sat in on the meeting. They were not allowed to address the board, but some wish they could have, still reeling from the board's abrupt firing of Joe Paterno.
A phone call? I mean, is that really necessary? I mean, if the news station were to fire you or I were to get fired, I would think and hope that they'd have the decency to do it to your face.
Irene Lubing's daughter is a Penn State grad living in Silver Spring Township, Cumberland County. She can't believe all trustees were really in the dark about the Sandusky allegations.
Maybe they didn't know a lot that was going on, but nonetheless, somebody in this day and age with the social network, somebody should have let them know. And even if they say all of them didn't know, somebody must have known something.
The Freeh report suggested the previous board gave former university president Graham Spanier too much power. He controlled many aspects of Penn State by himself. The new Penn State president hopes to change the culture at Old Main.
As we continue to develop the relationship between the board and my administration, that you not look at me as the sole point of contact with the administration.
And they also rearranged some committees that would be focusing on legal issues for the university and also implemented a new public comment policy for their Board of Trustees meetings. President Erickson also said that in October, Penn State will be hosting a national conference focusing on how to spot and report child sexual abuse. Now, on top of all of this, they had other business to attend to. They voted to raise tuition for in-state students on main campus by 2.9% and increase tuition on the Commonwealth campuses by 1.9%. So a busy day, Ron and Kim, for the trustees.
A lot on their plate. All right.
Certainly.